Finally, the circle is complete. And as you saying, very special unboxing for me. It's gonna be in my top five of the year, so. It's gonna be in my top five of the year. I know a lot of people might not have it in their top fives, but hey, this is me. Before I get into this review and start talking about the history and start talking about the sneaker itself, I'm just gonna let y'all know, bro. These are just my opinions, bro. This is what I like. If you don't like it, that's cool. I can't tell y'all what to do. But all the negative trash, this and that in the comment, like I said, I can't tell y'all what to do. Just like y'all can't tell me not to walk in the mall and call a shoe Trash Can Water or call a shoe Air Jordan Nathaniel. Y'all can't tell me not to do that, so I can't tell y'all not to comment. I'm just going to probably ignore those comments because I don't want y'all to kill my joy on this one. I ain't going to let y'all break my stride on this one because this is probably, and it's not a Jordan, which is crazy, but this is probably my most anticipated sneaker of the year. And I don't care what nobody say because these were so freaking impossible to get when they first dropped. They were so impossible to get. That I don't care what nobody say, I'm finna enjoy this unboxing. Finna see them for the first time. Shout out to my guy, Ron Gosserin, aka Ron G, down in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Came up on this pair. He came up on a few pairs, actually. And other than him, I haven't seen anybody review them in its entirety with the packaging and everything on YouTube. So I'm gonna put first look. I might put first on YouTube. Hey, you talking about? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? I might just feel a little jumpy and put that on there. But this right here, man. Ron G, I don't know where you get the box from. He looked like he had to get them to me quick. I don't know if he couldn't find a box and he just made a box. That looked like that's what he did. He just put a couple of boxes together and threw some tape on it. I don't care. I'm glad he got them to me expeditiously. I've paid a little bit over retail because my patience. I gotta have them now, bro. And if it's a chance that I get another pair for retail later on down the line, I ain't doubled up on the shoe in forever. I might not double up. I just need one pair. Just need one pair, Rich. Gotta talk to yourself sometime. Anyway, I hope everybody, each and every last one of y'all, is having a blessed day today. I ain't want to forget that. Let's go ahead and get into the email. Like, man, I don't really get this excited for sneakers this much, man, but I'm almost like nervous opening this package, bro. Cause if y'all knew, I don't care how long ago it was, and it was probably what 13 years ago. Damn, when this shoe, kids who were born when this shoe came out is in middle school now, bro. That's crazy. But when this shoe first came out, bro, it was like I will say, and I haven't used this word in a long time, grail. This shoe is a grail of mine because it's a new grail because it's not a shoe that came out in the 90s. It's a shoe that dropped in 2011, bro. And from the thumbnail, y'all probably know what it was if you know your history, but. I remember seeing images of these, bro, and being like, I had just started back collecting and I was like, bro, they being creative with this stuff, man. Let me get them. And when I found out how impossible they was to get, if you could find somebody on eBay or Craigslist selling a pair, you don't know if they was real, and they was going to be like the high resale. But from this box, you can tell it says KD35, as you can see. The theme of the box, you can see. You see it, the bright colors, the 90s retro vibes. You see that light green, Voltage green Nike. You see those blues and those all those vibes from like 90s, even though the shoe came out in 2011. And you see the KD 35, Kevin Durant 35. I want this shoe bad, man. I want this shoe bad. I'm gonna talk about some of this other stuff later because this is not how the shoe was originally packaged in 2011. We're gonna talk about that, but we're gonna get into the shoes first. So anyway, the official name is KD Nerf. It just tells you it's the KD4 Nerf, but it just says KD Nerf. KD Nerf, man, because this is the only, they did a splatter KD5 that kind of went off the vibes of the Nerf. I don't know if they could get the collab rights or how that worked back then, but this is actually a Kevin Durant Nike K Nerf, the actual company Nerf collab. Nerf hoop, Nerf the little Nerf shooters and all that stuff. Official colorway is Concord Bright Crimson and Black. Retail will be, say, I got to do my research for this one. This shoe drops sometime in July. I still don't get an exact date. It comes out in July. Everything I'm looking at just says July. So summer release. Retail will be $150, which is, I think, $130. Was the Galaxies was $130 and the Weathermans was $130. These will be $150, probably because of the box. And I'm so glad, before I open it, give me some time. I'm so glad that Nike, instead of completely ignoring the way the box came with an actual Nerf hoop on the inside, and it was this big square box. I'm kind of glad they ain't put it in there, because it wouldn't stack with the rest of my boxes correctly. It'd be awkward. But I'm glad they still went with the design of the box, because I thought they were just going to put it in that plain KD box, that black KD box that we've been getting the other retros in. I thought they was going to do that. But no, they actually gave it the Nerf theme. And I'm glad that they did that. An extra, $20? And I take it. Inside of the box has Vibes 2011 Vibes, man. When these was hard to get. Man, it has the KD animation right there. The artwork with the Nerf at the bottom. And the swoosh in that light green. Vibes! Here you talking about. Vibes, 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 man. You feel me? Oh, man. Oh, man. And then the rest of the inside of the box, before I look at the shoes, it give you that right there. You still get that little splat-cat-cow of Nerf coloring. And the reason the Nerf colorway they give you all these bright colors like this is because most of the stuff that they had was these colors. The little Nerf. Little foam, little shooters, and like the, I'm careful what I say on YouTube, I ain't gonna ask you. Y'all know what I'm talking about, the pion pion, and then the Nerf, I don't know if they had water guns or not, but I know a lot of Super Soakers back then had these colors, and I know just everything Nerf made, the toys for the kids and all that stuff, had these really bright colors to it. That's what made it Nerf. Nerf or nothing, y'all remember the commercial? So anyway, let's get into the shoes. I present to you. Yes, sir. I don't care what. Nobody say. Ain't nobody gonna take my joy on these. I don't care what nobody say. They could have came with some different laces, though. I don't think they ever did. But yeah, they only came with these laces, man. I finally got this shoe, bro. All these years. 2011, man. Me looking at, just looking at them online and being like, man, oh, dang. I ain't never think they were gonna retro these. Me! Pew, pew, pew. The KD4. And the Nerf colorway. KD4 Nerf collab, bro. Man, y'all don't realize it, bro. Like, I know there's a lot of people probably in the comments right now saying, Rich, that look like a GS shoe. That look like a kid shoe. You that excited about that shoe? Don't think trad can water. Y'all just don't know. You had to be there, number one. Number two, this is when Nike basketball was taking off. They started getting real creative with their sneakers, bro. They started to get real creative with their sneakers, and they was putting different things on shoes, man. People was trying to like Nike ID these colorways because Nike was actually stepping outside the box. Like, they only do stuff like this. Like, you would be right saying this look like a GS shoe because they only do stuff like this for GS. But my grown over 40 ass finna be walking around with some KD Nerf on because it's the nostalgia factor too. Having Nerf products growing up. You feel me? Just because something looked kiddie, you got to remember, a lot of stuff first came out, we were kids. Nerf been around since like the 60s or something, bro. So, I don't care who you are. I remember Cam Newton was saying something about Cam Newton from Atlanta. Shout out to Cam Newton saying something about age limit to wearing Jordans and stuff. Bro, I don't buy. I spend my money the way I want to. I could care less. Shout out to him. I respect him. But hey, you dress the way you want to dress. I don't think nobody in this world should be walking around looking like the Cat in the Hat, Mad Hatter, whatever. But that's your swag. That's your drip. I can't knock you for that, bro. I'm gonna rock this stuff. I don't care. Now, how I'm gonna drip these, I have no idea. Because jeans with these, like we did in 2011, that ain't the move no more. But y'all know what the Nerf look like. If you don't, this is the look of the Nerf. I keep getting that shine off of the strap because of the sun outside. But it was just something about that Concord purple just sitting so deep right there. I'm going to give y'all an outside look at these things too, man. Give y'all a sun look at these things. Here you talking about.
Sir, yes, sir. Shining a little light on the situation. Here is the KD4 Nerf. I want to say Weatherman for some reason. Man, these things cleansed in my humble opinion, man. Ooh, woof. Just want to give y'all some sunlight on these things, man. Colors is popping on these guys, bro. KD4 Nerf Gang. Woof. Man, I'm so glad they brought these back, man. Needing them in the collection. And now they are in these hands. What are you talking about?
Yeah, man. And it's just one of those shoes, bro. It's bright. It's colorful. It's a freaking collab, bro. And it's just, I don't know, man. Just they were so hard to get back then. And I wanted a pair. As you see, the KD35 and that splatter on the on that shoe. And then on this shoe, you see you actually have the Nerf. Actually says Nerf on that shoe in the yellow. You know what I'm saying? Got that bright crimson swoosh. You got that light, kind of like electric green on the KD right there. Bright. It got a lot of bright colors, man. It's a bright shoe. But it's just one that I've been wanting forever, man. I like I said, call me what you want, bro. But I had to have them, sir. I had to have them KD on the ass. Kind of got those speckles on the midsole. Got the gray in the back. Like I said, they tried to kind of recreate this drip with the KD5 coming out with them splatters. And I had those. If y'all remember some of my early reviews on YouTube, I showed those shoes a couple times. I had those. But it was not the same, man. You got the light green swoosh. Crimson on the bottom. You know what I'm saying? You even got the little Nerf splatter vibes going right here on the inside, on the little, like this little fiber carbon, not carbon fiber, but a little plastic piece right here. Man, I used to want these shoes so bad, bro. Now I will say I'm excited about this shoe. I'm probably nowhere near as excited I would have been if I would have actually got it back in 2011, 2012. If I would have got it back then, I would have been like, bro, I don't know when I'm gonna wear them, Shawty. I just wanted them in hand. I'm still excited, but like I said, excitement done went down a little bit just because of the fact that I am older and it's like I got so many. Back then, I probably had like 15 pairs of sneakers, you know what I'm saying? Maybe 10, maybe 12, something like that. I got like 300 pairs of sneakers now, and it's like every time I get a shoe, the excitement lasts a little while, and then a little while later, it just be like, whatever. But Nerf on the inside of the shoe right here. Nerf, and then on the inside of the other, and you see the splatter vibes across the liner on the inside. It just got kind of like that splatter, and then you have the Nike on the inside of that. It just kind of remind me of, like, you know how Jordan 7 just got that tribal pattern on the inside. They hit the whole inside of the shoe, stuff that people ain't gonna see. Look at the detail with the splatter. I wanted these so, and I know I just keep saying it, but I wanted these so bad back in the day, bro. Look, all the way down to the green on the inside right there, Shawty. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, this is the KD4 Nerf. You had to be there. And if you wasn't there, and if you like them now, hey, comment below. I don't know how I'm going to drip these. Some nylon black jogger, kind of like some sweats or something in the wintertime. And some shorts and a t-shirt with like something. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Something colorful. Maybe not this shirt, but you know, just something. Some might just put them on with something that pop. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm just glad I got the shoe in hand, man. You know what I'm saying? So before I leave, I'm just gonna say the significance of this shoe back in 2011. I have never, and I repeat, I have never seen anybody wearing this shoe on feet. And I've been to sneaker events. I've been to all kind of stuff. Like, everybody got limited pairs of sneakers on. I have never seen anybody wear these on feet. That's because they were so limited the first time. A lot of friends and family got them and stuff, and they were hard to get. A couple of people got them. The only time I actually saw the shoe in person was at sneaker events, when they were sitting behind the shelf in a case, and people wanted like $2,500 or $1,800 or $1,600, you know, stuff like that for them. And I never saw big sizes. This is size 12. This is my size. I never saw big sizes. And I never seen them on nobody's feet unless I'm looking at, like, this is how far back this goes. Unless I'm looking at 106 in Park and Wale or somebody like that walk on the stage and they rocking a pair of these, or some Weathermans or something like that. That's the only time I seen them. Or LeBron, Big Bangs and stuff like that. Nike basketball was really creative, but when they brought certain shoes out like this, they just made them limited. And a lot of people couldn't get them, and that's what drove kind of like the hype up for them. But if you weren't around, if you could remember how crazy people went over stuff like this back in the day, comment below. This was the hardest one to get. I think that's why I'm so excited about this one, talking about how it's going to be in my top shoes of the year, stuff like that. Because the Galaxies was I had a chance to get those. Weathermans, I had a little bit less of a chance. But these, I literally had no chance to get these. You were barely able to get them on eBay, bro. Especially in my size and size 12. You just couldn't find them, bro. They were limited. So anyway, it was a few more things I wanted to say about this shoe and wanted to say about, you know, the whole Nike basketball thing and all that. I can't remember. I'm just excited to have the shoe. I can't remember half of the stuff I was going to say now that I'm opening shoes, but I'm glad I got them in hand. Shout out to Ryan G once again for sending me these things, man. And there we have it, man. The KD4 Nerf. So comment below, tell me what y'all think. Even if it's bad, like I said, I can't stop y'all from saying they trash and all that stuff. But what I can say is, it ain't gonna stop me from liking them. My grade is, you should know from the review, my grade is a 10 out of 10. Absolutely love this shoe. It does look like a GS shoe, does look like a kid shoe, but back in the day, they was making these, man. KD rocking these things on the court playing for Oklahoma City, man. And I was like, bro, them clean, bro. Like, I wouldn't ball in them. I wouldn't play basketball in the shoe, but I like them. And I'm going to find a way to wear them. I just think the art, like, just the nostalgia with the Nerf and the artwork and how the detail, it's so much detail. I ain't even really show half of the detail. It's so much detail on this shoe, man. And it's just, I don't know. One of my favorite sneakers of all time is the KD4s in general. And my favorite KD4 is the KD4 Nerf. Probably right behind it, I put the Weatherman, and then third, I put the Galaxy. But now that I have all three, I'm a happy man. I will pull the other two out, but I don't know. Maybe I'll do that later on. This video done been long enough. But now I have the KD4 Weatherman, I have the KD4 Galaxy, and I have the KD4 Nerfs. That's the last of the Infinity Stone collection. I wanted to get all three of those. I did get that Year of the Dragon 2.0, but I returned it because it was too big and I never went back and buy it. Resale ain't that bad, so I don't know if I get it later on. But the three pairs that I wanted, I got it. And we capping it off with the KD4 Nerf. So anyway, comment below and tell me what y'all think. Hit the thumbs up, like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Hit that notification bell so you can become a part of Rich Nation. Stand all the way up to the moon on them and keep watching my video, because that's what I'm here for. Gone.
Rock money now. Special. Going to the moon on them. Yeah. Call up the plug, hit me a lick. Early hits from Retro Rick. New air bubble like helium lift. So extra blessed, thank God for the gift. Yeah, it's a hit. Premium fit. No barbecue, but this is it. Hold up, rock just might hit. With richest kicks, I mean my rich. Yeah. Ballin' all the way to the moon on them. Space Jam going on the tune on them. Sweeping y'all haters, get the broom on them. New heat coming real soon on them. Might rich fan shouted, that's what I cop the gift for. Thank you for watching these vids, that's what I'm here for. Gone all the way up to the moon on them. What's happening, everybody? Life so lottie daddy. Hit that Nike store just like your girl hit Hobby Lobby. Then we fly to Abu Dhabi, then we gone straight up to the moon on them.